Welcome to this detailed look at gateway cloning. Gateway cloning is a registered trademark and proprietary system belonging to ThermoFisher Scientific. During the two-step process, DNA fragments are transferred into and between plasmid vectors using a set of site-specific recombination sequences known as AT sites. The first step in gateway cloning is the creation of an entry clone through the capture of a single fragment of interest between AT-L sites using either an entry or donor vector. Entry and donor vectors are purpose-built gateway cloning vectors containing required AT sites, antibiotic resistance genes, and a CCDB cassette to allow for positive and negative selection. The CCDB cassette is located between the AT sites and is toxic to E. coli. Successful cloning replaces the CCDB cassette with the fragment of interest, ensuring only recombinant plasmids can propagate. There are three methods for creating entry clones: via PCR with gateway linkers, standard restriction enzyme cloning, or topo TA cloning. The PCR method begins by creating entry clones through a BP clonase recombination of a PCR product with a donor vector. Donor vectors include AT-P1 and AT-P2 sites, which recombine with a PCR product flanked by AT-B1 and AT-B2 sites. Add the required AT-B sites to your fragment of interest using PCR primers. After PCR amplification and cleanup, the fragment of interest is introduced into a donor vector using BP clonase. The result is the fragment of interest now flanked by AT-L sites. Alternatively, you can create an entry clone using standard restriction enzyme cloning. The restriction enzyme cloning strategy takes advantage of two multi-cloning sites on an entry vector. Entry vectors contain AT-L1 and AT-L2 sites with a chloramphenicol-resistant CCDB cassette between them. Successful creation of your entry clone replaces the CCDB cassette with the fragment of interest using a standard restriction enzyme cloning workflow. The third option uses topo TA cloning to create your entry clone. Several vectors allow directional insertion of a PCR product by topo cloning, introducing your fragment of interest between AT-L1 and AT-L2. Sequencing is always the last step in verifying the completed entry clone. The next step in gateway cloning is to create the expression clone by combining the entry clone with a destination vector. All destination vectors include AT-R1 and AT-R2 sites and are compatible with standard gateway entry clones, regardless of which method produced the clones. There are multiple families of destination vectors for common experimental goals, including protein expression and purification, fluorescent fusion proteins, and two hybrid screens. These vectors are adapted for all standard experimental systems. Destination vectors carry a different antibiotic resistance gene to entry vectors, allowing you to select for the expression clone easily. To go from entry clone to expression clone, use LR clonase to combine your entry clone with a destination vector. The AT-L sites will recombine with the AT-R sites, moving your fragment of interest from the entry clone to the destination vector. This reaction creates the final expression clone, which contains the insert flanked by AT-B sites. This clone is then ready for transformation and expression in a host organism. Multi-site gateway cloning can assemble multiple fragments into a single destination vector. Standard gateway cloning uses AT-B1 and AT-B2 to introduce a single fragment into the destination vector. Multi-site gateway cloning utilizes the site specificity of four other AT sites to recombine multiple fragments into a single construct in one step. As with standard gateway cloning, the first step starts with the BP reaction. In this case, multiple DNA fragments of interest are created that contain different pairs of flanking AT-B sites. To perform multi-site gateway cloning effectively, you need to plan how many fragments you wish to combine and in which order before choosing the correct entry and destination vectors. Each entry clone is built and sequence verified separately following the standard gateway cloning methods. These entry clones are used in the LR reaction. The corresponding at sites on the entry clones and the destination vector must align correctly. The compatible flanking sequences are recombined and incorporated into the desired destination vector to create the final expression clone containing the multiple DNA fragments of interest. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.